Yesterday, when I was teaching Sunday school, we were looking at the book of Matthew, fifth chapter, looking at the verse that talks about that if a man looks on a woman to lust on her, that he is committing adultery. So Jesus was putting everything on an equal playing field when he said, in essence, that sin was a matter of the heart. So if you hadn't done it, you just hadn't gotten around to doing it. Because if you perceive it in your heart, then it's as good as done. And God is looking at the heart of the matter. And it keeps us from making hierarchies of sin. And as you know, as we do in the world and we do with crime, and we would do, you know, there's levels. There's major things, there's misdemeanors, you know, there's felonies. But when it comes to sin with God, and all sin is, you know, except the sin of blasphemy, but it's an equal playing field. All sin has the potential of keeping us from the richness of the relationship we can enjoy with the Father, that intimacy, when we walk in love and obedience and doing the things of the Father. Anyway, there was a little confusion because I said, you know, when we put something before God, we can commit spiritual idolatry. God says, you shall have no other God before me. But because we are his bride, the bride of Christ, and God is our ish, our husband man, then when we are not walking in obedience, acknowledging God in all of our ways and making God first, loving him with all our heart and our mind and our strength. You know, when God is not first, then we are committing spiritual adultery because God is our husband man. We are the bride of Christ. And God tells us, you know, that we should not have any other God before him and to love God with all our heart, our strength, and our might. And the only way to do that is to receive Jesus Christ as our Lord and personal Savior. And then the Holy Spirit leads us into the truth of who we are in Christ, Emmanuel, Christ in us, the hope of glory. And that Holy Spirit sheds love abroad in our heart, which causes faith to work so that we can walk in the newness of Christ and choose to live out of the new heart and choose the mind of Christ, to have the mind of Christ towards things. So we need to continue to read Corinthians 13, to pray, to die daily, to read the book about faith, Hebrews 11, so we can understand that the God of love is pleased when we operate in love. And the God who is pleased by faith, which causes love to work, wants us to be faithful people. Faithful to God and faithful that God who's begun a good work in us will perform it until that great day. There's a song that goes, what is this that I feel deep inside? And it keeps setting my soul on fire. Whatever it is, whatever it is, it won't let me. And it makes me love my enemies. It makes me love my friends. There's a scripture that, you know, when we receive God's love, the love of God will constrain us, help us hold it together and do right. And we'll be singing, what is this? When I used to do this, I want to do this now, because it's the love of God. God gives us his love in our hearts, makes the capacity of our heart enlarged so that we can love him back the way he should be loved, so that he can reside in our hearts, so that we can make better decisions. And we've got to die daily so we can live in the new life of Christ and have that new heart and have that new mind. And don't forget, you are blessed to be a blessing.